Hello, stunt fans. Welcome to the Replay Manager Masterclass, where I'll be going over all of the different filming techniques that I used in Cenotaph and will be using from this point onwards. By this point, I'm assuming you've got the latest version of Blender installed and have a good understanding of the basic hotkeys and navigation inside the workplace. I've put a video link in the description that should go over a lot of the things you need to know about using Blender. But if you get lost at any point, I've also got my command overlay there to show you what exactly I'm doing. Next up, we need to install the Replay Manager into Blender. To do that, we go to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons, Install, find our file, and we install the add-on as the whole zip folder. To make sure that it's installed properly, we type replay in there, and yes it is, it's got the little tick there ticked on. This is the replay I'm going to be using inside Blender. Tommy starts underneath the building, turns right, does a wheelie, hits the handbrake, go up the stairs. At the top he'll do a quick U-turn, and then a wall bonk 360 down below. To bring up Replay Manager, we press N. And here it is in this tab here. We'll click import, browse to our Vice City user files, and we'll import the replay. Nothing seems to have happened. That's okay. We click focus in the hierarchy list, numpad decimal, and it should autofocus on the focus point. Next up, we need to make sure the whole replay is visible inside the timeline. So we'll just drag the end out here. Next up, we will hit this little arrow in here, open the summary, click off, and we're going to delete the existing clock, old weather, new weather, and interpolation. Delete those there. Make sure we're on frame zero. I think we'll set the clock to 7 a.m. We'll make the weather sunny and we'll reduce the interpolation to zero. We'll right click on each of these and insert a keyframe. So now we can see here that the starting frame has all those properties and those will be a constant throughout the rest of the replay. This next part isn't essential, but it is handy when it comes to making sure everything is in the frame when we go to record. We'll select our focus. Shift S, cursor to selected, Shift A, UV sphere, click this, and we'll set the radius to 1.26 meters. To make sure the sphere stays on the focus point, we need to click it in the list, hold Shift, drag it down onto the focus. And then if we hit play in the timeline, it should follow the focal point. What also gets imported with the replay is the camera, and this camera is basically the stock follow camera. When we open a camera, everything inside this highlighted area is what's going to be shown in game. Because this is a Vice City replay, I'll also import some of the Vice City map. That way we can better position our cameras and not clip through anything in the map. Now that it's imported and we hit play on the timeline, what we see in the view window should be pretty close to what we actually see in game. So let's get started making our own custom cameras. First of all, we need our 3D cursor to be in a position where we're able to find our new camera pretty easily. Now that it's there, we shift a camera, and the camera gets created where that 3D cursor is. The first thing we need to do with the camera is change the lens unit to field of view and set it to 70 degrees. And this is basically what the default FOV inside the game is. To set this to our new camera, we control numpad 0. And now we can toggle in and out just using the numpad 0. While we're inside the camera, we can change our locations and rotations in the item tab to the right. Generally, you should have your Y degrees set to zero, because while you can set the camera to do a roll like so, the sky in game is still going to be upright, so it's not going to look too good. We'll start off with the easiest camera, which is a static camera, and then work into the harder ones later on. So we'll make our adjustments to this first camera. So now that we're on frame one, we can press I and set location and rotation for this camera. Now we go into the Replay Manager tab. We change our camera to that new camera we just made. You can rename it in here just by double clicking on here. That way you can have multiple cameras per scene. And now we can export. Go into Vicity User Files and we can easily save over the existing replay.rep. Before we go in game and start recording, we need to open Cheat Engine. Click that button, find our game, open. Open a cheat table, replay camera tool. Ignore that, and we can click all three of these. So here is our first camera. Note that the time and the weather has changed, and the camera is exactly where we wanted it to be. But because of where it is, we can't see everything that's happening in the stunt. So let's add some more keyframes. We can use the timeline to scrub the different parts of the replay, make our adjustments, and then press I to insert more keyframes. So after a bunch of tinkering, I've got a new series of keyframes with a new camera movement. We can go into the Replay Manager. We've still got the camera selected and we'll export. And now this is our new static camera. Something we should go over is how the camera moves between its keyframes. The default is Bezier, which kind of smooths out the motion a little bit. The other alternative is Linear. We can use that by selecting the keyframes, Interpolation Mode, Linear. And what this does, it makes a constant movement. This is more suitable for long distance pan shots or shots where the constant rate is more suitable. Next, we're going to make a basic cinematic camera similar to the one that auto-generates in Vice City when you don't touch the mouse for a bit. I've already got my camera where I want it to be positioned. Then we'll go into Object Constraints, Add a Constraint, Track 2, click the little eyedropper, and then click the focus. So now it's going to be locked on continuously to my player throughout the replay, as indicated by this dashed blue line. However, if we were to export the camera as it is now, it's going to go in game looking like this. So to get around that, we select our camera, object, animation, bake, action. We're going to untick this first one and then tick the rest. What this does is set a keyframe on every frame of the replay for the camera. It no longer has this track 2 constraint. Now we can export. And now the camera works in game. Remember, anytime you use a track 2 constraint, you need to bake the camera. However, if we wanted to make changes to the camera afterwards, we can Control Z, and that brings everything back. So now I'm going to combine camera movements as well as the track 2 to make a moving cinematic camera. Now I have some basic keyframes set to this new cinematic camera. So now I'll bake and re-export. And here is our new cinematic camera that always has the PCJ in the center of the screen. Next, I'm going to do a chase camera. We'll add a new camera. Do the FOV. Drag it out a bit so we can see it. So now this camera is in position. To make it chase the focus, we hold shift, drag onto the focus, and now exactly like the sphere, it's going to be with the player the whole time. Problem is, the rotation is going to stay the same because the focus doesn't import rotational values, which is very beneficial for creating our own cameras. So now to make the camera rotate, instead of rotating our camera, we're going to be rotating our focus. We scroll on the timeline where we want our first keyframe, press I while the focus is selected, and we do rotation only. Progress into the replay a bit and make our changes. So now, as we rotate the focus, the camera moves with it. And we set more keyframes until we're happy. All my keyframes are in place. And because we're not using a track 2, we don't have to bake the camera movement. Select our new camera, export. So now we have a camera that is traveling with the player in a rotation that we specify. This is good for making our own Jiffy cams where we want smoother than mouse movements. Now we're moving into the tricky stuff, follow path cameras. We're going to add a curve path into our scene, tab into edit mode. We'll delete the first three because we don't need them just yet. We'll position our first dot where we want it. Yep, that looks about right. Grab the second, and then using G, we can position each dot the way we want them to be. To extend the path further, we press E. Yep, that's all good. And keep pressing E to extend our path outwards. Now my path is laid out, but you can see that it's pretty jagged still. So in the Nurbs Path tab, we can open Active Spline and we'll increase the order. And what that does is smooth out the path. Yep, that looks pretty good. Now we need to Shift S, cursor to world origin, add a camera. And this camera can get its field of view and whatnot fixed up. Now we add a constraint, follow path. Use the eyedropper to select our path. And it'll put your new camera on one end of the path, depending on which vertices you deleted earlier, but that's okay. We need to tick fixed position. And then this offset factor will determine where on the path the camera will be. So we can set our first one there, go into the replay a bit, and have it kind of lined up with our camera. All good. For this first path, I'll also add a track 2 constraint. So that way we can have our camera focused on our player the whole way through. We'll keep scrubbing over the timeline, keep adjusting our offset factor, and keep inserting new keyframes. It won't look like it's lined up at the moment, but that's okay. That's just the Bezier doing its job. Once you have all the keyframes put in, the Bezier would sort out its smoothing a bit better and everything will look okay. Now I have all my offset keyframes in place. Camera looks like it's going to be all right. So because we're using a track 2, we need to bake again. Select our new camera and export. Now we have our follow path camera. It looks pretty rough because I'm just doing a tutorial. And it does take a lot of time to get the camera looking exactly the way you want it, but I reckon it's worth it. I'm just going to quickly fix the part where the camera clipped through that pole earlier, and that should be all good. Anyway, on to our last tutorial, the dual path camera. So we're going to have one path for the camera and another path for a new focus point for the camera to look at. The most simple way to do that is to select our path that we've already got, Shift D to duplicate it. We'll go into that one, and then we'll start changing the vertices. And I'll get back to you in a moment. So now I've got two paths, one for the camera, one for the focus. We're going to Shift S, World Origin, Shift A, and a camera. This can follow the path of our camera path. There it is there. We're now going to add a empty, and we'll make it a cone, why not? And this empty will follow the new path. There it is there. Going to select back on our camera, field of view, 70, object constraint. Gonna add a track 2, and we're gonna select object empty. So now it's gonna be looking at that cone. Now we've got twice as much work to do, because we're going to be moving the camera and the focus at the same time as the player in a way that the player is always going to be in the shot. So we're going to select frame 1 or 0, whatever. Select our cone, make sure fixed position is on so we have offset factor. First keyframe, do the same for the camera. Now we're going to go into the replay a little bit. We're going to select our cone right about there, keyframe. Do the same for the camera. Control 0, make sure that the bike is in the frame. It is, keyframe. Go a bit further. Cone go a bit further too. Keyframe, camera, same deal. So now, the player comes into view. And if I go a bit further, the Bezier will not be acting in that way. Keyframe there, a bit more on the camera, keyframe there. There we go, that's a bit better. And we're going to continue this for the rest of the replay, making fine-tune adjustments as we go. Alrighty, I've added a bunch of keyframes for the camera and the new focus. And I made a few minor adjustments to the paths, so the camera worked a bit smoother. Actually, we'll make a quick adjustment here. Bring that back. One like that. Maybe the same on this one. All right, cool. So yeah, that's ready to export. And because I'm using a track 2 on the camera to look at that cone, I'm gonna have to select the camera, object, animation, bake, okay. Now I'm gonna select new camera and export. And here we have it, a dual follow path camera. This is kind of like a regular follow path camera, except the camera looks a bit more organic rather than having the PCJ in the direct middle of the screen the whole time. And of course, if you want to make any changes to that camera, you can just Control Z and it undoes the bake. Now, what if you wanted to do some music syncing? We can grab that little top left corner there. It makes a duplicate of the timeline. We'll click this little clock and we will select video sequencer. Now we can add and select sound. So now you've got your sound on the timeline. You can move it pretty easy. It's just click and drag. Unfortunately, you can't see the waveforms of the sound itself. So you gotta spend a little time lining up the part of the stunt where you want the song to do a specific thing. But yeah, that's as far as putting a song in goes. Then you can just time it with your keyframes and produce something like this. And that brings us to the end of the tutorial. Hopefully you learned everything that you needed to, and I hope that I see your advanced camera movements in future videos to come.